Hello students, in this video we are going to discuss about the multiplication factors and those uses. In day-to-day life, we people are using these multiplication factors knowingly and unknowingly. For example, kilogram. What is the meaning of kilogram? How many grams are equivalent to 1 kilogram? 1 kilogram is nothing but 1000 grams. So 1000 grams is the equivalent of 1 kilogram. See, look at here. The kilo is a prefix which is used as the multiplication factor to this gram. So kilo stands for 1000. 1000 grams, nothing but 10 to the power of 3 grams. So here we used 10 to the power of 3 as kilo. K is the symbolic representation of kilo. Kg stand for kilograms. So by writing like this, we people are representing the units in a simple manner to understand. So in this topic, we people are going to be discuss the uses of multiplication factors, how we are representing the multiplication factors. Now, the multiplication factors are SI prefix or a series of prefixes to units in the international system of units. See, these are all the standard notations they mentioned. In the next slide, I will show you. To reduce the complexity of the representation of a number, we use these prefixes to the units. See, for suppose millimeter is nothing but milli. What is milli? 1/1000 part is considered as a milli. Look at here, 1/10⁻³, nothing but 10⁻⁻³ meters we should consider as the millimeter. So this is the standard notation. And here one more point too we should remember is these multiplication factors are the powers having the base 10. In the third point I mentioned that prefixes are the bases multiplied and divided by the power of 10. And coming to the next point, pre means before, fix means set. So we are using before some set to reduce the complexity of the units. And coming to the use, already I explained here also, complexity to reduce the complexity of the number. And some SI prefixes I mentioned in this slide, yotta is nothing but 10⁻²⁴, capital Y, 10⁻²⁰, zeta, capital Z, 10⁻¹⁸, exa, capital E, 10⁻⁵, peta, capital P, 10⁻¹⁪, tera, capital T, 10⁻⁹, giga, capital G, 10⁻⁶, mega star, 10⁻³, kilo, capital K, 10⁻² hecto, and 10⁻⁻¹, deca, DA. And remember children, in all the positive powers except 10⁻² and 10⁻ⁱ, we have the symbols represented by the capital letters except 10⁻² and 10⁻ⁱ. This thing you should remember. And coming to the negative powers, -1 is nothing but deci denoted by small d, 10⁻², centi, small c, 10⁻⁻³, milli, 10⁻⁶, micro. Here one more point we need to notice is micro, as of all the letters, if you observe, names you observe, symbol is represented as the first letter. Either it may be the capital letter or small letter. But in case of deca, it will be the first two letters. But in case of micro, it will be mu. Why the scientist introduced the word mu here? Already we used m for the milli, so that's why the scientist introduced the word mu. 10⁻⁹, nano cars means the volume will be reduced, and that's why the manufacturer given the name as a nano. 10⁻½, pico, 10⁻⁵, femto, 10⁻⁸, atto, 10⁻⁻¹, zepto, z, 10⁻⁻¹, yocto, small y. These are all the symbolic representation of SI prefixes which are used as the multiplication factors. Thank you for watching my video. Please subscribe my channel, Wow Academy for Physics.